Ah, nigga. This lunch night is too bad.
You just only mama guy, man. Last time you keep me waiting for nothing.
I was drunk after the old fool's match. When I tell you, them fellas in Bosiba can't play at all.
Or they play a Calabash Rally team.
But naturally, we call ourselves the Calabash Cavaliers. We eat them raw. We carry Tina and all.
Team for Tina? Me know she could play.
She can't play, but she was with Spy.
Spy? It got Spy in that?
But how you mean? Them fellas in Bosiba ain't no with tactics at all. When you see she's scratchy nose, that means the fella I playing have a S in his hand.
Oh ho!
Every time you see she scream up she cheek to kill a mosquito, that means it's Jack the man holding. But the sweetest was every time she looked up to just the fan, that means it's Deuce in his hand.
That nasty Tina, that time she wore some short, short dress, showing she had hairy legs, when she knocked me on power toes.
Ah, Miriam, why does way she don't so?
You never look at she good. That woman and figure one is the same thing.
You really hit she for you. Anyhow, she helped me good last night.
I hope you didn't walk out the alley with she though.
Nah, man. She and a few others get a job in Chin Van.
Chin went too?
What do you mean? Chin wins so much money better than Calabash Cavaliers. He treats with the free drinks.
He wants a pardon, Daddy.
Sweet man, Harry.
But how he has long ago, boy? She just hold on to him like if he's a piece of gold.
Well, he does feel it too sweet.
If they tell me that you is a sweet man, I could understand that.
Well, I believe that every man sweet to some woman, and every woman sweet to some man.
I don't believe that. It has some fellas who can't even pick up at all. And some women, the same thing.
Well, most of you always want something we can't get.
Danny, you're throwing that at me?
Nah, I didn't mean that. Look, when you see I ready to take you on, eh? You gotta chase my way. Because every minute is...
I hope that will be soon. But Danny, what happened? You're mourning over Shirley?
Well, yeah. But I and woman finish. At least until I get a job.
I don't have to tell you again. You could play it cool by me anytime.
Maybe I feel some of the neighbors beginning to feel in something, you know.
You go let that worry you?
No. Let them feel what they want to feel.
Danny, what are you doing tonight?
Well, some of the fellas and them say we go be drunk the cinema and there for Bob to see a karate show.
Look here, Danny. You and me could go to 8:30 and sit down in the balcony if you want. You don't have to beg people for the money.
Mabel, if we go to theater together, you know what people will say.
They will say how I'm robbing the cradle and that Danny ain't have no mind going wrong with a woman twice the age. They will call me Ma Briggs.
I know you want to pose with me, but...
Danny, look. You could go as if you're going all by yourself. And 10 minutes afterward, I go leave and we go meet in the cinema.
What about the money?
I go bring it for you when I take back the rest to wash.
Alright. What about coming back?
Well, you could walk with me to, up to the junction by the driver wall. And then I could go on in front and you could follow some distance behind.
Alright. We'll go.
Nice. Balcony, eh? It's more romantic. Let me go to Hannah, Danny. Of course, your hand feels like soap.
And it's always feel cold in these air-conditioned places.
You see that couple down there, how they loving up so much, and the picture even start yet.
And them just make me laugh. They're not even watching the trailers.
They didn't come to see pictures, but to put on their own show. Once I see a couple kissing, every time the lovers on the screen kiss.
Well, I suppose it's safer to make love in the theater than in the Savannah Gardens. So much rapists are moving about these days.
A few years ago, it had a fella in the Savannah licking up the men
and raping the woman until he catch up with him. And you know the river man turned out to be a policeman?
I didn't still have him down yet. Hey, look who's seen long over on that side there.
You know
them? You're bound to know them. You might know the man, but look at the girl, good. You're bound to know she.
Oh, I know now. I recognize you. That is Carol Parker living near Piccadilly Street.
Yes. I always used to see she sitting down on the banister in the gallery looking out. But she was with me and I couldn't even try a thing. She used to look at me in a real sexy way. She real bad.
Don't make me laugh. She got a face like a mingy dog.
You know, see, she did. The girl got big, beautiful eyes. Skin like black velvet, smooth and nice.
It's not only the face. A woman must have a good body.
Carol Parker have the goods to go with it.
She looks kind of short and stumpy to me. And from here, she's a new Frankenstein sister.
Gosh, maybe you could raise down people there. You don't see how the old fellow only kissing short.
Where's he going?
Can't tell you that.
You mean you will hide that from me?
You see, he is the father of somebody I know could. I'm pretty strict. You would never believe he knew me like so.
It's so with them fellows when they reach that age.
And the man daughter must be just a little older than she.
Wait now. I think I know him. Surely father. He come up one day in Calabashari when he wasn't there to talk to Shirley. Tell me something. Your wife still with him?
Yes. And he supposed to be respectable. That is a man that has punched it once at a big shot in cocktail parties and here. I can't see between any papers. I wonder if Shirley know about this.
And she always feels her parents is this uppity kind of people who just talk with a mouth like a tie with a ribbon and a nose in the air like if it's smelling dog food.
Then people got more bacchanal in their life than me. Then there's a parade like if they're in the Secret Service.
Danny, the picture's starting now. Stop looking at the girl now.
She nice too bad.